On January 15, 1945, the American forces found two interesting dressed up Stuks from Kampfgruppen Upsilon. They were plated with sheet metal on the sides and on the engine deck of the vehicle. One of these vehicles has lost some of its plating in the fighting and would carry the codes for C Company, 81st Tank Battalion, 5th Armored Division. During the Battle of the Bulge, Otto Scorsini and the 150 SS Panzer Brigade were tasked with capturing the bridges over the Meuse River before the Allies could destroy them. As a part of Operation Greif, Scorsini used captured Allied uniforms and equipment. But to make this operation work, Scorsini needed more Allied equipment, but the request for this equipment fell short and the 15 Allied tanks requested only two arrived, and the company was flooded with Russian equipment by mistake. The Germans still tried to dress up several German vehicles, half-tracks and tanks like the Panther. These Panthers were made to look like an M10 tank destroyer and probably could cause for some confusion. They also used 5 Stuks and welded all sorts of sheet metal to them. But the mission never came off the ground and the tanks and vehicles were used wherever they were needed. The 2 Stuks found at Guermont were probably abandoned there, and one was abandoned in the field between Bagnes and Guermont after it ran out of fuel and had the marking C5 painted on it. The other one was found in Guermont and was booby-trapped. These 2 vehicles had sheet metal placed over the engine deck and on the sides, making it look like a small T-28. Of course, the T-28 never saw any service, and the Germans would never have modeled it after this tank. Some seem to think it should have represented a M7 Priest, but this is far stretched and would need a lot of imagination to see a Priest in this film. Of course, these Stuks were both painted in olive drape and had several American stars on all sides, one more than the other. They both had markings for C Company, 81st Tank Battalion, 5th Armored Division, which wasn't even fighting in the area at the time. Even though these Stuks look really interesting, these disguises weren't so effective in battle and would not have fooled anybody for long. The 2 Stuks that were found and archived were scrapped after the war, and what happened to the other 3 Stuks is unknown, but they probably were all knocked out and scrapped. These ersatz vehicles were a desperate attempt to get a foothold in an unwinnable battle, and even if they had more American equipment, I doubted that it would have made any difference. And by this time the battle was already lost. The men that would go on with this mission and were caught wearing American uniforms were tried as spies and shot, but so far as I know, the crews that operated the Panthers and Stuks would not wear American uniforms because they weren't a part of Operation Greif anymore. And when they were captured, weren't tried as spies because they were just assigned to an unusable vehicle, something that was pretty much out of their hands. But let me know in the comments below what you think this Stuk could have represented. I hope you enjoyed this video and see you in the next one.